get 100 plus 400. IA, IB, and then this guy gives me minus 4 plus 4, gives me minus 8 plus 4 gives me minus 4. And then I just do the standard matrix solution, and I get solutions for these. It looks like I get IA equals to minus 6.5 amps, IB, I get minus 9.3 amps. Okay. That is how we use mesh analysis right there. So if I sort of like summarize what I just did, let's write mesh analysis on the board so that we can compare these guys. So what did I do? I did this here. So I have mesh slash loop analysis with voltage sources. So the first thing that I do here is that I assign a loop current to all independent loops. Okay? Yes. Yes. It should be milliamps. I have milliamps on my notes. I just didn't put that in. So I assign a loop current to all independent loops, label them, and do the counting. What do I mean by do the counting? If I have two loops, I have two loop equations. If I have three loops, I have three loop equations. If I have six loops, I got six loops. Malcolm.
Is that only voltage sources?
Yes, only. Yeah, great. Only voltage sources. Okay. So in this case here, the number of loop equations equals the number of independent loops. And you'll see, this gets really tricky when we start adding current sources into the circuit. It's not trivial at all. You know, in some sense, people go, well, it's easier to do mesh analysis because you're not dividing. You'll see. There's a cost to this easiness. There's totally a cost. And that's when you have multiple current sources in a circuit here. And then what we'll do here is that then we apply. So now we apply the mesh equations to all independent loops. So how do I do that? So it's got to be the sum. So if I have two, then I sum two equations. If I have six loops, I have six equations that I got to sum. So I sum these, and it's going to be what? The sum of resistors connected to loop one times I1. And then it's the sum of the mutual. Then you got mutual resistors are subtracted, and then you get I2, I3, as many as you want. And then it's plus or minus the voltage source. So we've got to be careful. What do I mean by plus or minus here? Now remember what I said before here, like I wrote it. I'll draw a picture here, but I'll show you what I mean by this. So if I get a voltage source like this, and I have a loop current coming in like this here, let's call this is I1 for right now. If I1 comes in here, what does it do? Look what it does. I hit a negative sign. And then you'll hear me say, that negative sign, when I take it on to the other side, becomes plus 2. So then the sign convention for this is that this is a plus Vs on the other side of the equation. On the other hand, if it's the opposite, then what ends up happening, when I take it to the other side of the equation, you get a minus sign. So then the final step here is to solve the loop equations and interpret the problem. This may look to you to be all mathematics. It is not. We use mathematics as a tool. Our number one goal is to analyze what is actually happening in the circuit. That being said, we should set up a circuit. Be example